So let's look at the answer to our simple implementation quiz. If we issue the next access only when all prior accesses are complete, what is the memory level parallelism we get? And the answer is the memory level parallelism is exactly 1. Remember that memory level parallelism is about having a load that misses and gets sent to memory, and then our processor continues finding independent instructions here in the hope of finding another load that is a miss and sending it to memory while the first miss is still going. What that does is that if we look at all the misses in our program, we would do some execution and then wait for memory to respond, and then do some execution and then wait for memory to respond, then sometimes do very little execution and wait for memory to respond. So basically our execution with memory level parallelism of 1 ends up being the execution without the misses plus the time to access memory, which is very large, times the number of misses we have. With memory level parallelism, we execute, we send a request to memory, now we'll wait for it, but meanwhile we execute a little bit more and hopefully find that next miss, in which case we can overlap misses and hopefully we will find more than just 2. So in this case, we have that the cost of each miss in terms of memory access was not paid every time. We paid really the cost of maybe something like 1.5 misses total, but we satisfied 3 misses here.